Hey, math tutor here. Did you know that AP Calc BC does not cover everything that's in Calc 2? There are actually many things missing. I'll tell you what those things are in this video. But first, don't freak out, okay? None of these topics are actually essential. So if you do BC and you do well, then you'll be okay. You'll be prepared for Calc 3. After all, that's why colleges offer credit for Calc 2. If you do well enough on the AP exam, typically, I guess it depends on the college. But yeah, colleges are basically admitting that these topics are not essential. Okay, so here we go. Here are the topics that are not in AP Calc BC. Okay, partial fractions where there are repeating terms and or nonlinear terms. So, okay, just so we're all on the same page. This is an example of partial fractions where there are repeating terms. So see how these are repeating, right? Okay, so that's what that means. Now here's an example of partial fractions where there are nonlinear terms. And there's only one nonlinear term, actually. But yeah, this is not linear, right? This is quadratic, technically. Okay, so this stuff is not officially in AP calculus. So you know what that means? There is a 0% chance that you will see this stuff on the AP exam. Literally a 0% chance. Next thing, multiple iterations of integration by parts. All right, so just so we're all on the same page here, this is an example of what I'm talking about. This integral would require you to do integration by parts twice. Not cool. This is not a thing in AP calculus. You will never see it on the AP exam. Integrals that require trig identities. Yeah, you won't see that on the AP exam. Trig identities are basically irrelevant to the AP exam. Well, let me be clear. You do need to know the trig functions, like including tangent, cosecant, secant, and cotangent, right? And so I guess these technically are trig identities. So you need to know these four, but that's it. You don't need to know any of this stuff. None of the crazy trig identities, right? So just know these four right here and you will be good. All right, trig sub, yeah, also not a thing in AP Calc BC. Some other applications that integrals are missing. Don't get me wrong, AP Calc BC does have a lot of applications of integrals. See here. By the way, the ones in blue are also in AP Calc AB. But a typical Calc 2 class is probably going to have one or two more applications of integrals. Here are some examples. So the most common one here is definitely volume using the shell method. So maybe you would have this one, and then you would pair that with, one of these other three. But yeah, so different Calc 2 classes are different, right? So one Calc 2 class might have shell method and surface area. One might have shell method and work, or, but AP Calculus does not have any of these applications of integrals. Telescoping series, also not a thing in AP Calc BC. And finally, root test, also not a thing in AP Calc BC. Now, okay, I don't want anyone to be confused, so let me just make everything super clear. This is stuff that is not official content of AP Calc BC, right? So, as I said before, there's like a 0% chance that you will see this on the AP exam. Literally a 0% chance. Okay, so that's what I mean. I am not saying that like there are no teachers anywhere who are teaching some of this stuff. I've heard of teachers who just kind of teach whatever they want and stray from the curriculum. I'm just saying that this stuff is not official content. You will not see it on the exam in May. Also, I mentioned this before, but Calc 2 classes can be different. It depends on your professor, your math department, the textbook you're using. So, Calc 2 classes are different. So, I'm trying to generalize. I'm doing my best to generalize. I'm thinking of all the Calc 2 classes that I've seen and like, I'm thinking about what are the most common elements. Also, just to be clear, I'm talking about like a Calc 2 class that's a semester long. Some colleges are on quarter systems, but most colleges are on semester systems. So yeah, that's the kind of Calc 2 class that I'm talking about. All right, I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions, you can leave a comment down below. I'll try to answer that. And thanks for watching.